Which It Gets It, has published a video about the curvature of the Earth. He manages to have almost everything he says to be wrong. And, when he is right once in a while, he has left out crucial information. Part of this video is filled with the usual nonsense. The horizon is not physical, the horizon is converging into the horizontal vanishing line, the horizon is moving around, we see an apparent place, long hallways, showing examples of extreme refraction. He talks about when the surface is not flat, you can't have specular refractions. Deliberately confusing specular reflection with diffuse refraction. He thinks that because plane surveyors assume that the Earth is flat, the Earth must be flat. Ignoring geodetic surveying, a field that does not assume the Earth to be flat, but that has measured that the Earth is an oblate spheroid. He states that the curvature of the Earth is ignored in all engineering, whether building bridges, railways, building canals, which is a blatant lie. He shows a laser test that proves nothing at all, but this is not what this video is about. No, he takes my suspicion to the limit with this video fragment.
Now here's another problem with the globe Earth. If the Earth is a sphere, then it must be curving down and away from you in all directions. What that means is as you go higher, the Earth is going to be further and further away from you because it's going down and away from you and you're now going up. Well, here's what actually happens when we go up in altitude on the Earth. You see where the starting line is, you see the horizon, and let's see what happens as we increase altitude. Look at that, the horizon's rising with the drone.
First of all, let's assume that this statement is true. There are no gimbal tricks and the gimbal was steady at 1.5 degrees. Then the line of sight would be 1.5 degrees down and at the middle of the screen. Why has the maker of this video set the gimbal at 1.5 degrees? On a globe Earth, the horizon is dropping with altitude and even when looking slightly down. This is not what we see in the video. What we are supposed to see on a flat Earth cannot be calculated because there is no formula for the distance to the horizon. In fact, there isn't even an explanation for there being a crisp horizon in the first place. However, looking at a 90 degree zenith angle, the horizon most certainly will drop when gaining altitude on a flat Earth. Looking slightly downward won't make this situation much different, especially with a zenith angle of just over 90 degrees. But there is a much more worrying red flag, and that is the video itself. First of all, why just 15 seconds? Why not a longer video where the drone goes much higher up? The guy wouldn't go all the way to the beach and launch a drone for 15 seconds and then go home, would he? There must be more footage. Why not show it? I couldn't find the original video because Widget didn't give a link to it or any indication of where he got it from. Typical flurf. But it is much worse. What about the horizon staying exactly in the middle of the frame for the first 4 seconds? Although the drone is clearly rising, then the horizon rises rapidly for the next 8 seconds and at the end the horizon drops for 2 seconds. Let's look at it in a close-up. No movement. Upward movement. Downward movement. This all looks very fishy, to put it mildly. Although the maker states this 15 second clip proves flat Earth, no gimbal tricks, the gimbal remained steady at 1.5 degrees the entire time, this simply cannot be true. If the Earth were flat, quote none, then, according to the maker of the video, the horizon would rise and we would see more water at the same time. But this is not what we see. We see a stationary horizon, then a rising horizon, and then a dropping horizon, respectively. And, by the way, it is not consistent with all those stories of flat earthers who claim for years now that the horizon rises to eye level. But this flat earther claims to have proven the Earth to be flat with a video that is supposed to show a rising horizon. To put the cherry on the cake, he spends most of his time proving that high frequency microwaves above 40 megahertz do not bounce off the ionosphere, and therefore these cannot be picked up at greater distance than the line of sight distance to the horizon. He shows a list of record-breaking transmissions, a list I managed to find. He completely ignored the codes in the colored column. These codes stand for the atmospheric conditions that make these long-range transmissions possible. TR stands for tropospheric ducting. ES for sporadic e-propagation, reflection of relatively small high-density electron clouds at around 100 kilometers up. MS stands for meteor scattering, reflection enhanced by the presence of long-lived metallic ions deposited in the lower ionosphere by meteors. If he had done just a little bit of research into long-range propagation, he could have found this with only two or three mouse clicks. He hasn't researched it, or if he did, he deliberately failed to mention that these atmospheric conditions can provide anomalous long-range propagation of VHF signals. These are well-known phenomena. It is documented extensively, and it makes microwave transmissions possible over much larger distances than the line of sight distance to the horizon. This just about sums up the liability of Whitsitt when it comes to proving that the Earth is flat. We know that Whitsitt talks a lot, but in most of the cases, when we hear him talking, he is wrong. Dead wrong.